Go to the directory of llama.cpp. Let's compile the C++ project first. We pass this parameter g to enable debugging symbols. Run the make command. The compilation process is successfully completed. Run the main program of llama.cpp. LLaMA2 is the latest large model open sourced by Microsoft and Meta. Here we use the quantized 7B model that can be run by llama.cpp. Specify the number of tokens to generate. Use Linux as the prompt to generate the content. Run the command. You can see that the text content is constantly being generated below. Now open another terminal and run the top command to check the CPU usage. As shown, the main command of llama.cpp is using almost 400% of CPU cores. Let's use OpenResty XRay to check out this unmodified process. Open the OpenResty XRay web console in the web browser. Here we can analyze it in real time and find out which parts use the most CPU time. Make sure it is the right machine you are watching. You can choose the right machine from the list below if the current one is not correct. Go to the guided analysis page. Here you can see different types of problems that you can diagnose. Let's select high CPU usage. Click on Next. Select the target you want to analyze by processes. Select the process of the main program of llama.cpp. Make sure that the application type is right. Usually the default should be correct. The language level is just C and C++. We can set the maximum analyzing time. We'll leave it as 300 seconds, which is the default value. Let's start analyzing. The system will keep performing different rounds of analysis. Now it's executing the first round. The first round is done and it's on to the second one already. That's enough for this case. Let's stop analyzing now. It shows that the system is generating a report for the current analysis. We can see it automatically creates an analysis report. This is the type of problem we are going to diagnose. It's CPU. This is the number one hottest C++ code path for the CPU time. The first function ggml compute forward mulemat is a general matrix multiplication function in the ggml library. Its caller function ggml graph compute thread is responsible for performing single-threaded computation. Click more to see details about this code path. The code path was automatically derived from this CPU flame graph. Below are more detailed explanations and suggestions regarding the current issue. It mentions the function ggml compute forward mulemat. And it performs forward multiplication of matrices. Let's check the number 2 hottest C++ code path. The first function ggml vec.q4_kq8_k is a function in the ggml library for calculating the dot product of two vectors. Click more to see details about this code path. It mentions the function ggml vec.q4_kq8_k. It also mentions that it computes the dot product of two vectors. Let's go back to the second code path. Hover the mouse over the green box for the first function. We can see the source file of this function. And its full path for the kquants.c file in the tooltip. The source line number is 2608. Click the icon to copy the full C source file path for this function. Use the Vim editor to open the source file. And look at the C code in this file. You can use any editors you like. Go to line 2608 as shown in the report tooltip. We can see that this line of code is using bitwise operations in C to perform some operations on the elements of an array. We see in the status bar that this line is in the function ggml vec.q4_kq8_k as shown in the report. OpenResty XRay can also monitor online processes automatically and show analysis reports. Go to the Insights page. You can find the reports in the Insights page for daily and weekly periods. For this reason, you don't have to use the guided analysis feature. Guided analysis is useful for application development and demonstration purposes. OpenResty XRay is a non-invasive diagnostic system based on our own dynamic tracing technology. It can monitor and scan various kinds of problems in real time. For example, performance bottlenecks, stability issues, errors and exceptions, as well as security vulnerabilities. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.